Far Cry 6 is just around the corner, and while it won't include the franchise's famous map editor, creators from all around the world have been inspired to create their own Yara experiences using the Far Cry 5 arcade. Now, since this channel is all about player creativity in video games, I'm going to showcase 5 of these amazing maps along with a short review. Now, a quick reminder that all my feedback is purely subjective, and I'd like to thank everybody who took part because these maps got me super hyped for Far Cry 6, and I'm sure they're gonna do the same for you. The first map today is Island of Conflict, a really nicely designed creation where you take down an elaborate outpost on an enemy-infested island. The first thing I want to compliment on this map is the waterwork, which is really, really nice. I love the choice of rougher waves off in the ocean because it makes you feel genuinely trapped and threatened by the fact you're on an island, and there's a lot of detail on the coastline as well, with vegetation and rocks extending into the water, making it feel like the natural world expands far beyond the dry land. The other thing I really liked was that the way the man-made assets are placed on this map is really organic and believable. So for example, the town feels like it's been built around the rocks rather than just carved into them. It has a really nice, believable feel to it. There's also a really nice structure overall as well, where you explore a good chunk of the island, but without much downtime, so you don't get bored as you travel from place to place. It is paced really, really well. In terms of things to improve, I found the god rays on the beach where you start just a little bit too much. I feel like they could have been saved for some denser areas where there's a lot more shadow because they looked a fraction out of place. And some of the foliage is a little bit clumsy in places as you get further into the map, but it does kind of fit with the chaotic and wild theme. Overall though, this map is the perfect mix of linear and open-ended gameplay. It's not so open that you'll get lost very easily, but it's got plenty of opportunities for you to revisit and try a new approach each time. Oh, and bonus marks for the sheer attitude on this goat. Bit worried about his front leg though. The second map today is Ghosts of Yara, a really interesting map because it's actually set in an alternative timeline where Yara has fallen victim to the Great Collapse, also known as the nuclear ending of Far Cry 5. Now, the first thing I liked about this map is that actual unique take on the concept. This wasn't really what I was expecting when I asked for Far Cry 6 maps, but it's still close enough to the theme so that it could be included, and that slight different twist makes it stand out. The second thing I really enjoyed is that the whole map has this really orange hue that hits you right away, confirming that tropical Cuban setting, even though the island has seen better days. And the third thing I really, really liked is that there's some unique ideas in the structure of this map. If you take a few little detours here and there, nothing that screams in your face, but just enough so you think, wonder what's down there. If you do explore those potential avenues, you're often rewarded with some sort of scarce resource, ammunition, or just a cool little story from the timeline of the map. It really rewards that exploration. In terms of things to improve on this map, some of the more open areas felt a touch bare and offered very little cover in the heat of battle, but that is more than compensated for with the many custom structures on this map. Each of them alone would have been a highlight, but there's so many amazingly built custom structures and they just blend into the environment. It's a really big achievement. My personal favorite has to be the construction site. The lower level at the foundation is just so incredibly detailed. It looks so convincing, as if they were pre-made assets. It's a really nice map to explore. At the halfway point of the list today, we have the Cuban Revolution, a map that takes the concepts of guerrilla warfare and then applies them in an urban environment. And the first thing I enjoyed on this map was the starting area. It really sets the scene. It gives you time to immerse yourself in the world, and you actually accompany your allies as you move towards the combat zone. The second thing I really liked was the wide open streets, but they're very, very detailed and full of chaotic assets. They look amazing, it feels like a revolution's been taking place, but most importantly, it gives you cover. And that ties into the third point, which is that this map really captures the chaos. There's mortars falling, explosions going off, friendlies being gunned down, and it's just utter chaos. It really, really keeps you on your toes. In terms of things to improve on this map, I think the lighting is an area of potential. Taking the orange hue of the previous map, for example, would really bring out more of the tropical feel in this map, because it did feel like it could have been a city almost anywhere in the world. I really do like the end of this map though. It's a rooftop ambush where you go from being the hunted to the hunters, and it's a chaotic experience once again, only this time the enemies are on the receiving end of that chaos, and it just feels like by the time you finish this map, the tides really have turned. It was a good ending. The penultimate map today is Yara's Heart, a short but intense experience that really encourages you to keep moving. The first thing I liked on this map was the opening shot as you're selecting your classes. In the background, there is a really nice vista that sets the scene before you really do get your feet on the ground. The second thing I enjoyed is those classes actually. There's a really nice variety, allowing you to play in almost any style you like, and also adding to the replayability if you want to experience the map with some slightly different weapons. In terms of things to improve, some of the texture work was a touch harsh on this map. I think reducing the intensity and blending a few more textures would just ease the transition from, say, the beach to the jungle. And also, I think making the experience a touch longer would be good as well. But that said, I really did like the way this map was structured. If you go loud and you get your target, you then have to fight your way back through a whole lot of enemies with very little cover, but it's not so exposed that you can't make a run for it. So it rewards players who commit to stealth but punishes players fairly if they do go loud. It really feels like this map ebbs and flows. The final map today is Isla Escudo, and I have probably butchered the pronunciation, but don't let that take away from the fact this is an awesome map. I really enjoyed it because the creator has basically imagined their own ending to Far Cry 6. In this map, the revolution is nearing victory, and Anton has fled to this particular island with his lieutenants to try and survive. Now, the first thing I loved about this map is that it's very true to the source material. It has basically everything we've seen from the Far Cry 6 previews. It has hidden camps, guerrilla trails, Anton's royal palace. Chances are the things that come to mind when you think of Far Cry 6 are in this map. And some of the locations on this map are just truly epic in their scale. There's some amazing custom structures like this lighthouse, which I really, really enjoyed exploring. And that leads me to the third thing I liked about this map, which is just the variety in the gameplay. You fight indoors, in urban areas, on exposed beaches, or deal with extreme verticality and even platforming. There's just so much to keep you engaged. The one big thing I would like to see improve on this map is just adding a bit more life to the world, whether that's animals or some friendly AIs towards the end. It does feel a bit like it's just you and the enemies. Although that said, I do strongly suspect the sheer scale of this map means that there were some budget limitations. But overall, this map is just a massive highlight for me because you really feel like you live and immerse yourself on this island. There is just so much to see and do. My first playthrough was 40 minutes long, and I was ready to jump right back in. There's just so much variety in gameplay on this map that makes you feel like you enjoy every single minute of it, despite it being a fairly lengthy experience. It is a masterpiece of a creation. Once again, a huge thank you to everybody who took part in this showcase. And while it doesn't sound like Far Cry 6 is going to have an editor itself anytime soon, I will be continuing this series here on the channel using the Far Cry 5 arcade. I'd love for you guys to take part. And if you haven't taken part before but are interested, I will leave a link to our Discord server and also a video which explains the entire process, all the rules, everything you need to know if you want to get involved in the future. I also covered some really exciting upcoming creator games in a recent video, which I will also link in the description, and many of those will be covered here on this channel as they release in the coming months, so I'd love for you guys to stick around and check those as well. But until then, these have been the top 5 Far Cry 6 inspired maps. Hey everyone, thanks for making it to the end of the video. If you love the creator side of gaming, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, as it really helps out a small channel like mine. A link to our Discord is in the description, and on screen right now you can see some other videos that I think you'll really enjoy.